Hi everyone, I know that you're currently working on your technology reports, and so I wanted to share with you how the library can support you as you're conducting research for these reports. In the first video, we looked at how you can get started accessing library resources, and now we're going to discuss how you can find some background information that you can use to help you define a problem to explore in your reports. To get started on your assignment, you're going to want to choose a topic or project that is related to your program and that involves a need or issue that you can describe, analyze, and propose solutions for. So basically, you need to come up with a problem and propose a solution. A little while ago, I heard this guy, Jeremy Wang, speak at a conference. He's an aerospace engineer and entrepreneur, and he asked the question, what is more important, the problem or the solution? He's seen many tech companies come up with cool ideas, but a lot of the time, these ideas are solutions for problems that nobody really has or cares about. It's far more important and more difficult to define a key existing problem than it is to come up with some snazzy solution. So what are some strategies that you can use to define your problem? You're unfortunately not going to be able to come up with a problem out of thin air. When defining a problem, Google is going to be your best friend. Start by brainstorming and come up with a list of topics that you've been studying in class. Think about issues that you're interested in and then Google them. See what other people are talking about connected to your issue. This might spark an idea. Also, check the news. What are some issues cropping up in current events? Is there already a solution for these problems or is this a gap that you can explore? And then finally, explore existing solutions. Just because someone has already developed a solution for a problem doesn't mean that you can't build on it, adapt it, make it better. I really liked this quote from Christy Malekar, who works at the Canadian Urban Transit Research and Innovation Consortium. She says that innovation is taking two things that already exist and putting them together in a radical way. In your technology report, you don't have to come up with the latest, greatest solutions. Think about ways that you can repurpose existing work to come up with something new. Could a solution in one field apply to another? We've already talked about how searching Google can be a great way to spark ideas, but you can also use a science encyclopedia like Access Science to find background information in related research. To find Access Science, we're going to head on in to the English 250 research guide here. I'm going to go in there now. Once you're on the research guide, you're going to choose the research tab in the left-hand menu. On this tab, you'll see under background information, we have the link right there to Access Science. I'm going to pop in there now. Because I'm off campus, it's just going to ask me to log in. So I can log in using my employee number and my eCentennial password. You'll log in using your student number and your password. Once we get in, you'll see that Access Science has tons of great information on key science topics and ideas. You can browse through these existing topics to find one related to your program or search for a specific concept here. If you're in computer science, you might want to check out this computing and information technology section. This is going to provide you with a list of key topics connected to computer science and might spark some ideas. Maybe you want to explore telecommunications and remote sensing. Again, this is going to give you some subtopics or other issues that you might want to look into. Maybe you're interested in mobile communications. What are some of the trends going on there? This is going to bring you to an easy to understand background article, can identify some key concepts, can look at all of these key issues as you scroll through. Also on the side of the screen, you'll see some related articles that you can explore. If you already know a topic that you're interested in, you can pop it into the top search box. Say we're interested in 3D printing. I can do a search for that there. It's going to pop up for me a nice article that I can look at. So again, we get a list of articles. I can choose 3D printing, and then we'll be able to find this nice, easy to understand background article that I can take a look at. So now we've looked at how you can find some background information resources that you can access. In our next video, we're going to look at how we can search strategically to find evidence for our technology report.